Today we had another stream. So first of all, for the Majesty Lord Blaster deck, they have shown us card names. Now, obviously we don't learn that much from it, but there is one really interesting thing. We now know that you will have four grade threes only in the MLB deck, Majesty Lord Blaster, obviously. You will have Blaster Blade, Blaster Dark with a new skill, Star Call Trumpeter, which is a new card, a Knight of Silence Galatine, same skill, Wingle Brave, new, a Knight of the Harp Tristan, which is a solid reprint, Cloudlancer Gamoris, same skill, Pluck Enchanter, same skill, Barkle, Vogel, Lou, Isolde, Elaine, just a trigger lineup. However, there's also one new order card, something something light and dark, so apparently it's gonna be an exciting one. I'm hoping it's not going to be over-costed like the other ones. You know, as we've said, the order cards we've seen so far, while strong, have had massive costs, probably to make them not too great and just teach us the mechanic. I'm wondering if this is going to be the first, like, really impactful one. It'd be pretty odd, though, to put that in a deck. Well, a trial deck. It's going to be more than a trial deck, but because that would force lots of people to buy that deck, even if they're not Royal Paladin fans. We'll see about that. Maybe it's an MLB-specific card, but just interesting to see. We'll be getting an order card in that deck. Now, we've also seen a trial deck card for Neonectar, Blossoming Maiden Sella. Continues on R. If you have a unit with the same card name as your Vanguard on your R, this unit cannot be retired by card effects and gets power plus 5k. So because of the Asha token thing that copies the power and I believe name as well, this card will always be a 15k and then also not be retireable, I believe. Now it also has an act on V and R, cost CB1 and call up to 2 plan tokens to R. It's not great for premium because it's an act, so it doesn't work with Katrina. And again, a CB cost isn't necessary when this deck knows everything for free already. However, it is, you know, fine-ish in standard. It's still a trial deck card, but I think it's a pretty solid trial deck card, which is pretty rare. So also pretty nice art. So if you're into that, maybe you enjoy this. Then we have two Gear Chronicle cards. We have Smoke Gear Dragon. Oh, this is a triple rare from the next stage set, as far as I'm aware. On auto, on V and R, when it attacks a Vanguard, this unit gets power plus 5k until end of that battle. If you rode a grade 4 this turn, Soul Blast 1 and draw a card. So this is just free plussing on a beat stick. Pretty solid card, and in the standard Gear Chronicle deck you will always have Road to Grade 4, technically speaking. Also continuously on R, if your Vanguard is Chronojet Dragon, when you would discard a card from your hand, it may be discarded as a Grade 3. So essentially, as long as it is on R, anything is correct fodder for the discard skill. And more importantly, I believe this also works on strides. So the second this is on the field and you have a Chronojet Dragon as a Vanguard, everything's a stride fodder. So that's a pretty cool card. It's not super flashy, it's just a consistency buff, which we can appreciate in this kind of deck. But then, of course, the card we have all been waiting for. We also have Next Stage. We already saw this card in the anime, and so we had a pretty alright idea of what it did, but it wasn't really enough because we didn't know the costs behind it. We didn't know if there was like an extra restriction, maybe no restriction. And so now we actually know. It says at the end of the battle, so it's a grade 4, meaning you get it from the deck of Chronojet Dragon. At the end of the battle that it attacked a grade 3 or greater Vanguard, if your soul has a Chronojet Dragon, cost discard 2 cards from your hand, retire this unit, ride a Chronojet Dragon from your soul as stand, and until end of turn, that unit gets power plus 15,000 and you cannot ride. So first of all, your opponent needs to be grade 3. That means this is going to be a going second deck, or we're going to be running other that are already like have some kind of skill that's useful. Maybe it's the Metallica Phoenix, maybe it's some of the older ones, because we still want to be able to instantly get our stuff off, as far as I'm aware. Maybe I'm missing something again. If you're a Gear Chronicle main, you probably have some really in-depth thoughts about this already. But yeah, that's pretty solid, because Chronojet has a guard restrict. You know, they can't guard with Sentinels. He also gains power, and how he gets even more power from this. Maybe this deck is able to go Force 2 even. You know, that'd be pretty interesting. Maybe this is a Force 2 deck. And then on top of a guard restrict, you don't lose drives either. I don't know, that could be pretty good. Do let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. That was all for today. I will see you soon. Ciao.